Pastor Kadri. Today we are continuing with the substrate of heat and heat energy in environmental activities. Our topic today, we are going to learn uses of heat in the environment. Now, before we carry on the uses of heat, we have to understand what is environment. Environment is the surrounding. It can be here in school and also at home. Now, we are going to look at the uses of heat. One of it is ironing. When your clothes get creases, what we do, we iron them so that they can be straight. And the ironing, you have heat in it. Now, cooking, also cooking is use of, you use cooking heat. We cannot cook without heat. Also, we have warming. When you feel cold, you sit near a fireplace or you sit under the sun so that you can feel warm. Also, we have drying. Now, when you wash clothes, we dry our clothes under the sun. And those people who eat omena, they don't eat omena when they are wet. They have to dry them under the sun. Now, from there, we should learn how to conserve heat energy. For us, before we carry on, we should ask ourselves, what is conserving? Conserving is using heat well without wasting the heat. Now, we ask ourselves, how can we conserve heat energy? We can conserve heat energy by turning off the electric cooker when immediately we finish cooking. You make sure after cooking, especially when you are cooking ugali, when you are removing ugali from the electric cooker, you are supposed to turn off the electric cooker. We carry on to the next point, how we can show how to conserve heat. Now, when you are cooking githeri, you're not supposed to cook githeri with the electric cooker because you are going to waste the heat energy. So you are supposed to light the charcoal, jiko, because when you cook githeri, it will take too long to be cooked. Another point is setting the electric iron box at the correct temperature when ironing. Remember, if you don't set it at the right temperature, it can still destroy your clothes. So you are supposed to make sure you set the electrical iron box at the right temperature. Then the another way we can conserve the heat energy, it is lighting source of heat only when we are ready to use it. Now, remember, if you want to cook tea, you first prepare everything before lighting the any source of heat which you intend to use. The last one is timing ourselves when cooking to avoid wasting heat energy. Now, this one means that, like now, if you are cooking tea or you are boiling water to cook ugali, you should know how many minutes the water is supposed to boil, so that you wait there and you do your cooking without wasting the heat energy. And that is the end of our lesson. Stay blessed and safe.